Hey guys, Dropship Tyler here, and today I'm gonna be going over the top three reasons that I believe you're not making money with eBay dropshipping. Now, there's a lot of concern in the community right now with the way eBay looks at retail dropshippers and flagged accounts and how you can get around it and how you can make money. And there's a lot of other YouTubers talking about how now you shouldn't even be doing retail arbitrage dropshipping. That you should be going and finding wholesalers and this and that. I still think that retail dropshipping on eBay is the best business to get into if you're a complete beginner with e-commerce. So that being said, I want to go ahead and get into the mistakes that I believe that most people who are losing money on eBay are making. Reason number one, you're pricing your items too high and you're not getting enough sales to cover your current expenses. So let's go over some of the reasons that you would have to price your items higher than other people and that would cause your items not to sell. One being the fact that you're not tax exempt from the source and it's a popular source and everyone else is tax exempt that can get tax exempt. So you're essentially competing with a 7.5% higher markup than what your competitors are having to compete with because of the fact that they're tax exempt at those sources. Another reason is because of the fact that you're not calculating your back-end margin into your overall margins. You're thinking that you need a 5-10% front-end margin, and that's your goal, is to have that margin overall. Well, you need to consider the fact that there's discounted gift cards out there, and the fact that there's cashback websites, there's websites that track price drops. All of that stuff in the long run gets built into your overall margin. Most of the successful dropshippers that I see nowadays on eBay and Amazon, they're either tax exempt, using discounted gift cards, using cashback sites, all of that, and pricing their items close to break even and just making tons of money on the back end with some small profit margin on the front end. The other option is to use sources that nobody else is using or sources that you can't get tax exempt at. An example of a source like this would be Lowe's.com. I've mentioned in the past that they have terrible customer service, don't ship items out on time, all of that. I've actually found out now from talking with some other people that that's not the case anymore in 2019. And as long as you're staying on top of the shipments, you're calling in customer service when you need to, Lowe's is a fine supplier to use and nobody can get tax exempt in all of the states like they can with Home Depot or Walmart or Overstock or, you know, the other big suppliers out there. And the reason being is because you actually have to go to the store and get a tax exempt ID number. And you can see this on their website actually. So you have to travel to all the states that you want to be tax exempt in and actually get that tax ID number in. It's a really crappy process. Not sure why Lowe's is doing it that way. But I also found coupons, and I was using coupons before, and the coupons are $10 off 50, $20 off 100, or 10% off your overall order. So that's something to look into. You can price your items almost at the same price as they are on Lowe's for some of the different products. And with discounted gift cards and the credit card cashback you use to buy the discounted gift cards, the cashback websites and the gift cards, you know, you're gonna be making money even if you price that item at a very, very low markup. So that's an option if you're not tax exempt, is to find a source just like that. The number two reason I see why people are losing money on eBay is because of the fact that they're not listing quality products and they're not deleting and replacing products on a daily basis. In the past, eBay was very, very easy. You could just upload tons and tons of items. The more items you had, likely the more money you would make in the long run. Ever since the flagging occurred on April 20th, there is now a different approach you need to take, and that is doing everything perfect and making sure you have as many high quality listings as you can in your store going through on a daily basis, using a product research software such as Chili Hunter or Zeek Analytics. And also just, like I said, making sure that you're going in and you're deleting everything that hasn't sold in the last 30 days and has never had a sale. And I actually have a 3-2-1 rule, which I talk about in my course. And the 3-2-1 rule to me is this. So if an item sold three times or more and it hasn't sold in the last 90 days, go ahead and delete it. If it's sold two times and it hasn't sold in the past 60 days, so two times total and it hasn't sold in the past 60 days, delete. And if it's sold once and it hasn't sold in the last 30 days, go ahead and delete it. And obviously anything that's never had a sale, delete that item. That's my 3-2-1 rule. If you follow that rule, you're gonna have a lot of high quality products in your store. You're gonna be getting rid of the ones that cost you insertion fees, it costs you on software plans because you know you have more items. And yeah, so that's my advice to you about deleting your items. The number three reason that you're losing money is because of the fact that your expenses are just too high. When I'm saying expenses, I'm talking about software cost. I'm talking about, you know, your insertion fees, your VA cost, anything that is obviously helping you run your eBay business specifically. One of the big things that I'm preaching nowadays is that if you're just starting with eBay dropshipping, do things manually to start. You have zero cost if you just do everything yourself, up to 50 listings, that's what eBay gives you. You're paying a little bit extra of a final value fee. You're not able to use some of the features that if you had had a store, but you have the advantage of literally having zero cost every single month. So that's a big one right there. Some of you guys have hired too many virtual assistants and you're afraid to let somebody go. I promise you, these virtual assistants, they don't expect that much from you. If you need to let them go, they usually find another client within a few days, I would guess. There's so many other people looking for virtual assistants out there. There's so many different other online business options for these people to work in. I don't think you have to worry about the well-being of your virtual assistant. Even if they do try to make you feel bad about letting them go, I really believe that there's just so much more work than there are virtual assistants out there, especially qualified virtual assistants. So if you have a virtual assistant that you need to let go because it's costing you too much money, just do it. They will understand. They understand that this is a business. They are a freelancer. They will find another person to work for. Thanks for watching, guys. And if you don't mind clicking the like button, I would appreciate that. Leave a comment about your thoughts on this video and go ahead and click that subscribe button if you're not subscribed. Thanks, guys.